IT's over, Alabama just picked a new senator that nobody saw coming. After one of the most dramatic special elections in my lifetime, a winner has finally emerged to take over Jeff Sessions' old Alabama Senate seat. For the first time in several decades, a Democrat now represents the great state of Alabama in the U.S. Senate. That's right, Doug Jones beat Roy Moore. The sad part about this election for Republicans is not just that we lost a major U.S. Senate seat, it's that the honest-to-God truth is we easily could have beaten Doug Jones if anyone other than Roy Moore had been our candidate. Maybe you remember a few months back when President Trump and A.G. Sessions had both strongly endorsed Luther Strange to take the old seat. That is because they both knew what we know now, Roy Moore was unelectable. It wasn't just the alleged dating teenage girls issue that did it. Roy Moore was simply a guy who many people find disagreeable. He was a loose cannon with a horrible campaign staff. In fact, the only reason he won the primary and we're in this position was because of the support he received from Steve Bannon. Otherwise, we would be congratulating Senator Strange right now instead of lowering the Republican majority to a measly 51 seats. This is not good for the party, either. Since McCain almost never votes Republican and Jeff Flake might as well be a Democrat these days, we only have 49 votes left. That is not enough to pass anything concerning the wall, DACA, Obamacare, etc. We do need to remember, however, that this is not a rejection of the Republican Party or the MAGA agenda. This is entirely a rejection of Roy Moore and, if we remember that, we can still win big in 2018. It is now more important than ever that Republicans manage to win the 2018 elections since now our majority is in a bad place. We got to get everyone we know out to vote or else we are in for a very long 2 years. Like always, leave a comment and let's work together to make the USA great again. It's not over till it's over.